Do you ever fear your friends are having a good time without you? Do you ever get anxious when you know your friends went out and you had to stay back home? When you go on vacation, do you keep tabs on what your friends are doing? Do you feel like you spend too much time keeping tabs on what everybody else is doing? Is it important to you that you understand your friends' inside jokes? And do you get bothered if you miss a chance to hang out with your friends? If you answered yes to any of those questions, chances are you might have FOMO. So stay tuned for this week's episode to learn about what FOMO is and what exactly is happening in the brain when you experience the fear of missing out. FOMO was added to the Oxford Dictionary in 2013, and what FOMO is a fear of missing out. They define it as a feeling of worry that something interesting is happening without you. Now, I'm sure this is something that lots of you have felt. I've felt it before, and it's something that in modern society leads to a perpetuating desire to check social media and see what everybody else is doing. Now, the thing about social media is most people only post the good and hide the bad. So for everyone observing, it seems like it's all fun and games, and that can lead to this feeling that you're missing out on something. Now, it's said that FOMO comes from unhappiness, and with it, we experience highs and lows. So with that, we look at our social media as a drug episode on NeuroPsyQ, and you can go back to that and see that with social media, we have a lot of the highs and lows that come with addiction. And so FOMO can help to kind of put a band-aid on this unhappiness, but then at the end of the day, there's the issue that this is just a band-aid, and underneath, there's still problems. Two sources suggest that to improve FOMO and reduce the amount of FOMO you experience, you want to try and improve your attention. Now, we talked about mindfulness in another week's episode, and that is one way that you can improve your attention. But basically, focusing your attention on the present moment and not worrying about what else is going on in the world can help you to be present and reduce FOMO. The other thing these two sources both suggested to reduce FOMO is to increase your gratitude. So they suggest things like at the end of the day, writing down something you're grateful for to refocus your attention on that rather than focusing on the fact that, oh no, you missed Patricia's birthday party. Now, FOMO is something that's actually common in adolescents, and what we have seen is that with this fear of missing out, there actually comes a reduced amount of sleep, and this interferes with the sleep quality of adolescents, because when they have the fear that they're missing out on something, often they'll be checking their phone late at night, which can decrease the length of their sleep, increase their amounts waking up in the middle of the night, and also increase their latency to fall asleep. Which means overall they're getting less sleep, and we also talked about sleep in many other episodes and how it's important for cognition. So this can lead to devastating effects on the adolescent mind. Another thing is with especially university students is the fear of missing out rather than leading to just looking at social media and seeing what's going on. It can also lead to students staying up late to go out with friends or just to be a part of social events. And then reducing their amount of sleep to make sure that they can do all their assignments and complete coursework in a timely fashion. On top of that, adolescents find themselves in Erikson's stage of psychosocial development where they are dealing with identity versus role confusion. And so being around peers plays a huge role in them figuring out who they are and who they can be. And this progresses into young adulthood, when they are faced with intimacy versus isolation, and they are faced with the question of whether or not they can experience love. Now, talking about university students, one study on the fear of missing out took a group of university students, all in first year, and had surveys being sent to their phone throughout the day over the whole semester. And what they saw is that throughout the week, as Friday approached, the fear of missing out increased, and also throughout the day there was an increase in fear of missing out as well. So in the mornings that didn't really seem to be an issue, but towards the end of the day people started to experience their FOMO and it became more prevalent. And what FOMO is it brings about these feelings of negative emotions and anxiety. These feelings seem to be brought about because social isolation seems to activate the same regions as pain. So particularly we have activation of the insula, as well as activation of the anterior cingulate cortex, and activation of the prefrontal cortex in regions that are associated with pain. So social isolation and rejection can lead to the same feelings as of pain as an actual physical painful stimulus, which leads to this anxiety and fear, because when you're separated from a social situation, you don't want to experience that pain, and so you experience FOMO. Now, if we want to talk about the complexities of pain, the reason why we feel pain, it's actually pro-adaptive in that when we feel pain, usually we were in harm's way. And so pain acts as a lesson, teaching us to avoid a certain stimulus. So things like the fear of heights or a fear of snakes, it's all about promoting survival. And social connectivity is just as important to survival as avoiding a dangerous situation is. In fact, being socially isolated can be dangerous and detrimental to your survival. So, missing out on situations or social activities is causing this FOMO, because in the past, in order to survive, it was important that we stayed connected with our social groups. And so if you miss out on opportunities like that, we are experiencing a negative reaction to it, which is portrayed as fear of missing out. So that answers our question of why people experience fear of missing out. It is because we want to maintain social connectivity. There's actually this theory called the self-construal theory, and it says that there are two different types of self, either an interdependent self or an independent self. And there have been studies showing that Western civilization tends to have more of an independent self, and other civilizations are more interdependent, in that their idea of a self relies on the others around them. Whereas in Western civilization, it's more of a this is who I am rather than this is who we are. Now the thing is, with FOMO, is they say that people who are interdependent experience this FOMO more because they see themselves more of a unit. But that's not true, because people in Western civilizations experience FOMO just as much. So this ends up actually being more of a situational thing, in that if you were given a situation, which was done in a study, and the situation was either you go out with your friends, you do an assignment, or you're reading. The people in the situations that were doing assignments or reading experienced more FOMO, logically, rather than the people who got to go out with their friends. Other studies have shown that fear of missing out leads to more alcohol consumption. It is also associated with higher social media use, and in people that were primed in an interdependent scenario, reading words such as we, are, or us, they displayed more FOMO than people who were primed with independent situations. Now, individuals who have a lot of FOMO tend to have decreased mood or increased depression and a decreased satisfaction with life. Now, we talked a bit about the neural correlates, again mentioning the anterior cingulate cortex as well as the insula being activated with the fear of missing out, and these are things that are activated with physical pain, we said. So in a study that was done where individuals were in an fMRI machine and they played this game called cyberball, where it's basically just virtually passing a ball from one person to the next. In the game, they were put into a test scenario where their partners were excluding them and not passing the ball to them. And what happened in the fMRI when people were experiencing exclusion was these pain regions lit up. So there was an increased activity of the insula and the anterior cingulate cortex. which are areas that light up when we feel pain as well. So what this is saying is that social isolation or being left out causes pain. And pain is not something we want to experience, but this pain can also propagate into FOMO. Now, with FOMO being a kind of new term, there's not very many studies out there that show the neural correlates. There are a lot of studies that show neural correlates of social isolation and rejection and how those align with pain. And these just propagate into the fear of missing out. Just like how anxiety is coming from fear of something that would cause pain, social isolation causes pain, and that leads to the anxiety. So at the end of the day, just to remind you of ways that you can reduce this fear of missing out and reduce this anxiety, remember to pay attention to the situation that you are currently in and make sure that you are present in your moment rather than letting your mind wander. Again, meditation can help with that. And also be grateful for what you have rather than focusing on what other people have. If you need some tips on how to reduce your addiction to social media, if that's something that you keep on checking, which is just feeding your fear of missing out, you can check out our Is Social Media a Drug video. And if you wanted tips on meditating or you want to learn a little bit more on meditating, check out our meditation video that we posted just a couple weeks ago. So, just again to recap what we learned, FOMO is a fear of missing out caused by anxiety when one is experiencing social isolation. It can be improved by improving your attention to your current situation and reducing distractions based on what everybody else is doing. It can also be reduced by improving your gratitude. And the neural correlates for the fear of missing out are actually the same correlates that cause pain. So we have activity in the anterior cingulate cortex and we have an activity in the insula when somebody experiences a fear of missing out. Also on top of that, fear of missing out is more common in people who have an interdependent sense of self, and it can lead to reductions in sleep quality, which can also propagate to poorer academic performance, reduced attention, and also decreased immunity, because sleep is important for all those things. So again, thanks for watching. We hope you like this video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Share it with all your friends. And leave any suggestions for future videos you have down below. And that's it for today. We hope to see you next week with another episode of NeuroPsyQ. Thanks for watching.